In this video, we're going to cover a few examples of negations of statements that have quantifiers in them, such as all, some, at least one, none, and there exists. Our first example is, what is the negation of some cars are Fords? Well, the negation will be, all cars are not Fords. But oftentimes, students will put down the negation as, some cars are not Fords. That seems to be the correct negation. But why is this incorrect? Well, you have to realize that a negation of a statement and the statement always have to have opposite truth values. If one is true, the other has to be false, and if one is false, the other has to be true. And if our negation was some cars are not Fords, in the event that some cars were Fords and some were not, both of these statements could be true. You know, if half the cars were Fords and half were Chevys, then it would be true that some cars are Fords, and it would also be true that some cars are not Fords. You can't have a statement and its negation having the same truth value. But if some cars are Fords is true, that means all cars are not Fords has to be false because some cars are Fords. So the negation I have of all cars are not Fords is the correct negation. And there's a rule of thumb for this. You negate some are with all are not, and you would negate all are with some are not. So let's apply this rule to the following example. What is the negation of there is at least one dog that does not wag its tail? Well, to apply this rule of thumb, I'm going to rewrite this statement in the form some are or some are not. And the way we would rewrite this is some dogs do not wag their tails, because that's the same as there is at least one dog that does not wag its tail. Now, once we rewrite it in this form, some do not, we negate it with all are, or in this case, all do. And our negation is all dogs do wag their tails, or we could just write that all dogs wag their tails. Here's another example. What is the negation of no bugs bite? Well, we start off by rewriting it as all or some in that form where we can apply the rule of thumb. In this case, we write it as all bugs do not bite. Now we can apply that rule of thumb. And the negation of all do not is some do, so in this case we negate all bugs do not bite as some bugs do bite, or we could simply say some bugs bite. Now we can check this by seeing, are the truth values always opposite? Let's assume no bugs bite is true. There is not one bug in the world that bites. Will the negation some bugs bite be false? Well, if no bugs bite, that means there can't be one bug biting anywhere, so some bugs bite has to be false. So yes, the truth values are opposite. Let's assume no bugs bite is false. If no bugs bite is false, that means there must be some bugs biting somewhere, and that means the negation some bugs bite is true. So we get a yes for this as well. When the original statement is false, the negation is true. So we've shown that the negation is always false when the original statement is true, and it's always true when the original statement is false. And our rule of thumb works really nicely.